intercepted there. That would have been ball game if he had clinched it and caught it. Instead, it gets him one more chance here on fourth down. Back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep down. It got his man complete. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Randy Moss, 75 yards. And the Broncos have taken the lead. Might be seeing that one on the highlight shows tonight. The home run ball here in the fourth quarter to take the lead.
There's nothing like being aggressive, preaching that to your team, and then following through all the way through. Go ahead and throw one more up there. Why not?
Been a great game, and we are not done yet. This will make it into the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
Take over first and 10.
About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. They're only in need of a field goal. A decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
They practice all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. Back to throw. He's going to let it fly. And he can't corral it. That would have wrapped it up if he'd been able to hold on. Instead, it brings up third down.
Brings up
an important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
On third down, Gannon. Jackson's got it over the middle. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game.
First and 10.
So first and 10 now from the 30. He's back to throw. Bringing it in, Jackson left side. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. As the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play.
First down.
So two first downs, and that moves the ball to the 42 now, first and 10. Off the play fake, Gannon. He'll buy some time right. Now a desperation throw deep downfield.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. So it was past the line of scrimmage when he threw it.
And as they say, that's a no-no. Got to be able to understand where you are on the field and not cross the line before throwing the ball downfield.
Rolling to his right. That's complete. It's Kyle Juszczyk. Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout as he'll stop it with 13 seconds left to play. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. They'll look to throw. And he finds McLaurin. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down.
45-yard line.
Play action, Gannon. The attempt on the dive, and he has it. What a catch.
That's good for a Green Bay Packer.
Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still... You're wondering, could it happen?